Hey guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs for RBI SEBI NABARD. Let's begin today's video, but before that, if you have not subscribed to our channel till now, then do subscribe it at the earliest, because it is going to help you in keeping up with the latest updates on our channel. This is the Telegram group which you can join to enjoy the free quizzes that we provide on our channel. The link is in description below. This is the new course for 2022 RBI Grade B. Here we will provide you with PDFs, videos, mocks and mock interviews. Also, you will get a book kit which will include all the books mentioned in front of you right now, and 30% discount is something that we are running on this course right now, which is a bonus for you guys. You can avail this discount by using RBI30 coupon code. And in case you have any query related to the course, then you can just call us on the number flashing on your screens. On this number, you can call us if you have any query. So let's begin with the first question. Which of the following organization has launched the low carbon.earth challenge in partnership with UNEP? Oh, option A is Society for Environment and Development, Forum of Activities for Community Environment and Center for Environment Education, WWF India, Massive Earth Foundation. So out of these options, the right answer is option E. That is Massive Earth Foundation and UNEP, United Nations Environment Program, both have collaborated to launch this low carbon.earth program, particularly in the Asia Pacific region. Now, what is the purpose of launching this program? The purpose is basically to promote these startups, to provide a platform to the startups that are doing extraordinary work, that are making the products which are sustainable. So in order to promote those goods in different fields like automobiles, like agriculture and like construction. So these are different sectors. So all these startups that are creating innovative products that are sustainable also, in order to promote those startups, this challenge has been launched. So in this challenge, what the organizations are going to do, they are going to support these startups and make the products made by those startups easily accessible to the people, so that those products become the part of their lifestyle. Now, what is going to happen if these sustainable products that are eco-friendly as well become the part of our lifestyle? Obviously, these products are going to reduce our carbon footprint. And if the carbon footprint of each and every individual living in the Asia-Pacific region is reduced, then it is going to significantly impact the climate change. So that is the overall purpose. That is to promote these products that are sustainable in different segments, so that the carbon footprints of the people can be reduced by bringing a change in their lifestyles. So that is the purpose of this low carbon.earth challenge. Now, I hope that this challenge is clear to you. Low carbon.earth. It is very obvious from its name itself. Reducing the carbon footprint of the people by way of promoting the products into their lifestyle, promoting sustainable products into their lifestyle. Okay. So I hope that this is clear to you. Now I am moving on to the next question. Which of the following statement is true about enforcing contracts portal? First statement is, it aims to promote the contract enforcement regime in the country. It aims to reinforce the contracts made by Exim Bank with other countries. It aims to increase the project exports. It aims to promote foreign direct investments in the country by strengthening contract enforcement. It aims to enforce the financial contracts solely. So the right answer here is option A. This enforcing contracts portal, first of all, you should know that it has been launched by the Department of Justice under the Ministry of Law and Justice. Now guys, this is going to strengthen the law and order for strengthening the contract enforcement. The overall purpose is to boost the ease of doing business in India, because if the businesses have the confidence that the contracts they are going to enter into will be reinforced at any cost, they will have the confidence in the law and order, and only then they are going to be confident enough to promote business in India. So this is in a way going to provide support to the foreign companies as well. This is going to increase the confidence of the foreign countries in the system of India, in the law and justice system of India, particularly in relation to the contract enforcement. Here you have to remember, the contracts are solely in the field of commercial, so we are talking about the commercial contracts here. Okay, so the overall purpose is to strengthen the contract enforcement regime in the country, so that the ease of doing business can be promoted. Okay. Now guys, I would like to ask, who is the Union Minister of Law and Justice at present? So you have to answer this question in the comment section below. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विथ वेयर इज कुंडाकुलम न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट लोकेटेड. आंध्र प्रदेश, कर्नाटक, ओडिशा, केरला, तमिलनाडु. आउट ऑफ विच द राइट आंसर इज तमिलनाडु. कुंडाकुलम इज अ प्लेस इन तमिलनाडु एंड देयर दिस न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट इज लोकेटेड. नाउ व्हाई इज दिस इन न्यूज? द रीजन बिहाइंड दिस बीइंग इन द न्यूज इज दैट रशिया हैज स्टार्टेड द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द फिफ्थ न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर विच इज to be constructed at this nuclear power plant. So a total number of 6 nuclear reactors are to be constructed at this power plant, out of which the fifth one, the work on the fifth one has already been started by Russia, and because of this, this nuclear power plant was in the news. My question from you is that you have to tell me how many nuclear power plants are there in India, the total number of nuclear power plants. This is your question that you have to answer in the comment section below. Next question is, which state has decided to set up district level industry and investment promotion agencies to create more economic opportunities? Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Uttar Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Telangana. The right answer is Odisha. So the purpose is clearly to boost the industrial opportunities in different districts. So that was all about this question. There is nothing much that you have to memorize in relation to this news. Next question is, what is the name of the portal launched for enabling the parties to file their appeals, miscellaneous applications, documents, paper books, etc. related to income tax electronically? So you have the 5 options, out of which the right answer is option D, ITAT, IDWAR. So this ITAT stands for Income Tax Appellate Tribunal. So this portal has been launched in order to facilitate all these procedures online. That is the whole purpose of launching this platform. So you have to just memorize the name of this platform and remember that this ITAT stands for Income Tax Appellate Tribunal. Okay, on that note, I would like to ask you, who is the chairperson of CBDT right now? Central Board of Direct Taxes. So this is the agency responsible for collecting the income tax. So, and we are discussing income tax, so it is very obvious that we should know who is the chairperson of CBDT. Tell me in the comment section below. Next question is, who has won Fukuoka Prize for 2021? So Vijay Kumar Singh, Jogi Ranjan Panigiri, Gaurav Kumar P. Sainath, Kumar Padma Pani Bora. Out of these, P. Sainath is the right answer. He is a journalist and he has won this award. Now you should remember that this award is given by the Fukuoka City International Foundation, which is located in the city named Fukuoka in Japan. So it is basically an award given by the organization located in Japan. And what is the purpose of giving the awards? The purpose is to celebrate or honor the people who have done extraordinary work towards conserving different cultures in Asia. So that is the purpose of giving the Fukuoka Prize for 2021 to different people. So guys, that was all for today. I hope that you have enjoyed the video, and if you have, then do not forget to like it and share it among your friends. Thank you so much.